dear medicos, our channel Medical Students Corner is back again with another video. Most of the medicos think that neurology is a difficult subject, but it is not like that. So we will start our session with neurology itself. Yesterday itself I told that we'll be having symptomatology discussion. So let us first discuss about headache. ആർക്കെങ്കിലും തലവേദന വരാതിരുന്നിട്ടുണ്ടോ? ഇല്ലല്ലോ. സോ എവ്രിബഡി ഇൻ ഹിസ് ഓർ ഹെർ ലൈഫ് ടൈം ഹാവ് എക്സ്പീരിയൻസ്ഡ് ഹെഡേക്ക്. സോ ദിസ് ഇസ് ദ ഫസ്റ്റ് സിംപ്റ്റം വെൻ ന്യൂറോളജി ഈസ് കൺസിഡർഡ്. സോ വാട്ട് ഈസ് ഹെഡേക്ക്? വാട്ട് കോസസ് ഹെഡേക്ക്? വാട്ട് ആർ ദ വാർണിംഗ് സൈൻസ് ഓഫ് ഹെഡേക്ക്? വാട്ട് ആർ ദ ടൈപ്സ് ഓഫ് ഹെഡേക്ക്? ഹൗ വിൽ വി എവാലുവേറ്റ് ഹെഡേക്ക്? വാട്ട് ആർ ദ ഇൻവെസ്റ്റിഗേഷൻസ് ടു ബി ഡൺ ഇൻ ഹെഡേക്ക്? സോ ലെറ്റ് എസ് സീ വൺ ബൈ വൺ. Headache. Headache is the pain which is arising from the cranial structures. Any pain that arises from the cranium is known as headache. So there are so many causes of headache, but only less than 5% is due to some serious illness. So what are the reasons behind headache? Whether there is any pathology behind headache? Yes. Our Harrison says that there are two pathologies behind headache, or two reasons behind headache. So we will go with the reasons first. The first reason is that when there is stimulation of peripheral nociceptors or pain receptors due to some underlying conditions. The underlying conditions may be one, head injury; two, it may be due to vasodilatation or any other causes that leads to stimulation of the peripheral nociceptors. The first reason is stimulation of peripheral nociceptors. And the second reason is the pain pathway of the nervous system. It may be central nervous system or peripheral nervous system. It will be damaged, or what happens is the pain pathway will be stimulated inappropriately. It leads to headache. So these are the two main reasons that causes headache. I repeat, one is the stimulation of peripheral nociceptors. Second is damage or inappropriate stimulation of pain pathway of the nervous system. So do you know which nerve is responsible for headache? Yes, it is the trigeminal nerve. Trigeminal nerve is the nerve which sends pain in the cranium. So trigeminal nerve is responsible for headache. Whether all the cranial structures can sense pain? Is it so? Whether the brain can sense pain? No. There are only some cranial structures that can sense pain. Please remember these five structures. The first is scalp. Second is the middle meningeal artery. Third is the dural sinuses. Four is fourth cerebri, and the fifth is the proximal part of large pile arteries. So these are the five structures which can sense pain, and the rest of the other structures cannot sense pain. So the five structures, okay, you repeat. One is, yes, scalp. Second is middle meningeal artery. Third is dural sinuses. Four is fourth cerebri, and fifth is the proximal part of the large pile arteries. So if these are the only structures that can sense pain. So we have discussed already that only 5% or less than 5% of the headache are due to serious conditions. Rest of the 95% are not so serious headaches. So how will be understanding this is due to a serious disease condition? The patient will be presenting headache only. So it is difficult to differentiate. So there are some warning signs or red flag signs. Very important. There are some warning signs or red flag symptoms of headache. So let us see what are the red flag symptoms of headache or what are the warning signs of headache. The first warning sign is sudden onset of headache. So the patient says, I have headache. It came suddenly. I don't know that I will be having headache. There is sudden onset of headache, or headache rises to its intensity suddenly. That is, I had a headache, suddenly it rises within 5 minutes to its greater intensity. So the first warning sign is sudden onset of headache. Second is worst headache ever. The patient experienced headache worsely. This is the highest, worst, intense headache I had experienced till now in my lifetime. If the patient says that, you should be very careful. It is a red flag sign. Third is first severe headache. Worst headache or first severe headache. I used to experience headache, but this is the first severe headache I had experienced. If the patient says like that, you should be very careful. Next is when the headache is associated with constitutional symptoms. What are the constitutional symptoms? What may be the constitutional symptoms? Fever, fatigue, then when there is weakness or something like myalgias like that. So the headache is associated with constitutional symptoms. Then next is when the patient experiences headache and the patient is having some systemic illness, you should be very careful. Next, when the headache is associated with raised intracranial tension. How we can understand there is raised intracranial tension? One, the pain is aggravated when getting up from lying or when coughing or when lifting. Or when the headache is associated with vomiting, there may be some raised intracranial tension with that patient. If the patient experiences symptoms along with headache, we should be very careful. Next, when the headache is associated with local tenderness, pain with local tenderness, the patient may say, I'm having headache. Along with that, I can feel tenderness here. When we are palpating, he will be feeling pain. So when the pain is associated with local tenderness, and at last, Harrison says age of onset is above 55 years, but the Davidson says age of onset is above 60 years. At last, when the age of onset of pain is above 55 years, we say it is from 55 to 60 years or above 55 years, the pain may be due to some severe underlying conditions. So today we have learned what is headache, what are the reasons of headache, what are the pain sensing cranial structures, and what are the warning signs of a severe underlying illness in headache. Thank you for listening. We'll be back with classification of headache, investigation and evaluation in the next video. Happy learning. Stay safe. Keep in touch. Please subscribe. Thank you.